All new at 11, COVID-19 variants are circulating, so health experts across the state are really encouraging people to consider getting the COVID-19 vaccine if you're still on the fence. ABC Action News reporter Haley Bull is taking a deeper dive into what Florida labs are now finding.
I admitted our first patient. Hopefully I'll admit our last patient in the not too distant future.
Dr. Andrew Myers has been fighting COVID-19 from the front lines at Tampa General Hospital, where researchers are looking for variants of the virus with sequencing tests.
We have seen some of the P1 variant, and then the Delta variant is what is starting to ramp up. We haven't seen a ton of that yet.
Dr. Myers says they've seen a handful of the Delta variant, one causing concern over how transmissible it is.
Where before, we would kind of say 15 minutes in the same space with someone was kind of our benchmark. Now it's, you know, much lower.
The CDC says the national proportion of the Delta variant is predicted to increase from 9.5% to 20.6% for the two-week period ending June 19th to become the second most prevalent lineage. USF's Thomas Unash is closely following the data.
And we're also seeing pretty decent competition from this Gamma, this Brazilian one as well. So these are the two that I think over the next 3 to 4 weeks are going to become the dominant variants.
On the other side of the state, Dr. David Andrews is studying the variants too. Thanks to concern over the Delta variant, they took a snapshot. He says they sequenced about 60 samples from patients finding predominantly the Alpha variant, a quarter of samples reflecting the P1 variant, and two samples of the Delta variants.
I don't think that we would be any different than the rest of the country in terms of the Delta variant expanding, particularly, almost exclusively actually, in the unvaccinated population.
The latest state data shows about 57% of eligible Floridians are vaccinated.
We love for everyone to be vaccinated, but, you know, the more contagious a virus is, the more people we need to have vaccinated.
In Tampa, Haley Bull, ABC Action News.